Hello and welcome to this tutorial. Today we are going to export a Trium 3D Builder terrain database into Unreal Engine. The tutorial is divided into four sections. In the first one, we are going to generate and export the terrain in Trium 3D Builder. In the second one, we are going to set up the Unreal project. We will enable the DataSmith plugin and we will add the Trium 3D Builder import widget tool. In the third section, we will import our terrain into Unreal Engine. Finally, we will make some post-processing tweaks to get better performance and a nicer look. To follow along with the tutorial, you need to have installed Unreal Engine and Trium 3D Builder. If you don't have a license, you can download the trial version from our customer portal. There you will find a lot of interesting stuff, including the tutorial files. Let's open it and take a look to them. The project is called Bangen and it has been created by combining OpenStreetMap and HereHD data. With Trium 3D Builder, you can export to different formats a lot. Today we are going to use Unreal DataSmith, but first of all, let's take a look at how it looks like inside Trium 3D Builder by generating it in OpenSceneGraph. For that, press F9 or go to the main bar and press Build. And done. We see there are no errors, that's a good thing. Let's see how it looks like in 3D. I will say it's pretty nice. Have everything, markings, traffic lights, trees. I think we can export it. And check the open scene graph and choose Unreal DataSmith. I like to delete the terrain folder too, and then we won't see anything after that because we just deleted all the generated 3D. And now it's the same procedure as before. Press F9 or press Build on the top bar. I will speed up that part. Okay, and that's generated. Let's open the terrain folder. It's off screen now. Okay, and here we see the Unreal DataSmith files. Those are the ones we want to import into Unreal Engine. Let's open Unreal. We are using 4.25. I recommend to use that one to follow this tutorial. And well, it's quite quick. I don't think I need to speed up that part. And here we create a new game project. Okay, the first thing we need is to enable the Unreal DataSmith plugin. For that, go to Plugins and search for it. It's called DataSmith Importer. There is a bunch of DataSmith stuff here. And here it is. Okay, enable it. Yes. And restart. Once activated, the Unreal DataSmith plugin will show up on the top menu bar. The second thing we need is to copy the Trium 3D Builder Unreal import tools into the content folder of the project. Let's do that in the Explorer. Okay, that's my project. Let's locate the content folder. Here it is. Here is where we are going to copy the import tools. If you have Trium 3D Builder installed, you will find the import tools under the Trium 3D Builder folder in your documents. The path may vary depending on the directory you have used for the installation, but the most common is that one. So copy that folder and let's paste it into the content folder of our project, of the Unreal project we are working with right now. And We can see it here. Step accomplished. So now we can start importing our terrain. Locate the folder with the Unreal Datasmith files we have just generated in Trion 3D Builder. Copy the path and activate the Datasmith plugin. Okay, paste the path and select the assets. We just want to import the assets with the Datasmith plugin. Be sure the content folder is selected and press OK. Import it. And that may take a bit. I'm gonna speed up that part. Once you have all the assets imported, material, geometries, textures, we need to import the actual placement of all of them. So for that, run the utility widget. And here, be sure the terrain folder is selected. That's the one we had created in Trion 3D Builder. And here, be sure that the name corresponds to the name of your Unreal Datasmith assets. In my case, it's Vangen underscore. The underscore is important. So everything before assets. So here I write Vangen underscore. And here is the range of tiles. So in my case, in this case, we have just one tile. That tile is x0, y0. We could have more, we could have three, and that's a bit like that battleship game. It's also important if you have like a huge terrain with tons of tiles and you want just to import a few, like a small area to check something, then you can directly call in the utility widget which area you want to import. In our case, 0, 0 is fine, and let's import it. And down, let's check it out. Okay, here is the traffic sign, here is a bench, and here is Vangen. Right now it is still compiling the shaders, but it's looking quite nice. Now let's tweak the scene in Unreal to make it look even nicer. First I'm gonna create a folder called Lighting. And I'm going to add all the lighting stuff inside. Also, we may want to save the project. Let's save that level. I'm gonna call it Vangen. Okay, it will take a bit. The next thing we are going to do is like changing the light source to movable, as well as the skylight. And now adding a post-processing volume is not a bad idea. The post-processing volume is like amazing. You can do so many things. There is bloom, there is ambient occlusion, there is like the reflection. I'm just tweaking the exposure. I just want to like tweak it a bit. I'm playing a bit with that to achieve like a nicer look, a look that I prefer for that, maybe something like that. But you can like make really many things with that. It's some super nice stuff to play with. Other thing you may want to do is checking the materials. That's a material instance. It's an instance of that material here. And if we see here, the ambient occlusion map is not connected to the slot. So let's connect it and save it. And now it will look nicer. And also all the instances that depends on that material will have, as we see here, the ambient occlusion slot already with a proper map. For that one, maybe want to tweak the specular a bit up. So, safe, and yep, now it's looking nicer. And that's all for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did, and see you next time.